In this video, I draw up parts of the city of Innase and discuss how I'm going to populate it and how I will make it the centerpiece of the World of Tiglath campaign. This is the city of Innase. This is in Campaign Cartographer. This is going to be the center point of the restart of the World of Tiglath. So I've populated some of the city, as you can see here, that I've drawn up a bunch of the city in Campaign Cartographer, and the party's been into previous party has been into some parts of it. That's why there are a couple of labels around here. I want to fully draw out the city. Let me explain my rationale about my approach to designing the campaign. So this is actually a fairly large city, and this is an ambitious project. I want to fully draw up the city, drop all the buildings that are here, and the floor plans for some of the more important buildings, and then from the number of buildings I can calculate the approximate population, or actually the real population, because I have some tools that will generate you tell it how many people in a city, and it will generate all the people, it will generate all the number of services, number of taverns, and so on. Then I have to go through and name them all and figure out where they are on the map. But that's the approach I want to take with Innase. Now, once I have the population, then I will use 10% of the population, or 90% of the population is first level. Or for every 10, well, let me put it this way. For every 10 first-level characters, first-level NPCs, there will be one second-level NPC. For every 10 second-level NPCs, there will be one third-level, and so on. All the way up till I figure out who's the highest level in the city. Then we've populated out the city. We know who we pick out all from the top. We work our way down, picking out the important places. And I'll have names for all the first-level characters, even all the NPCs, just because I can programmatically generate them. But that's after I know how many buildings. So for me, I need to know how many buildings. And I already see some problems. Like right over here, this was programmatically generated. But that's okay, because I will get to a lot of the challenge with Campaign Cartographer's random street generation is that it tends to do things a little odd, and you get some odd house placement through that. So let me just show you. So here we've drawn a nice secondary street. So now we can say we're going to populate that secondary street with houses. So we pick the street, and we pick here, and it will up. Oh, let's cancel. We want to get into here. We say we want houses on the left and the right. So now then, when we pick this option, we start doing, okay, we pick the road, and we start populating the houses. And when the roads turn, you know, so it leaves some gaps here, which is actually a good thing, because now we can put a road going from here to here to here to, let's come down here. And we can cut. Now notice it's curved. So that's giving me that's the wrong kind of road. So I'm going to undo that road. Sometimes it doesn't stick. So that's a minor irritation. So with Campaign Cartographer, actually we can do road here, through here, here, through here. We're just going to come here and and go here. That gives me the nice road. Now we're not gonna, we're gonna put some build, we're gonna, well, actually let's do that now. So I want to put a road from here going this way. It's going to be fairly close. Now then, what I'm going to say is I'm only going to put built houses on one side of that road. So that's where we're going to pick. I think that's the right. Or let's see if it's on the left. Let's try the left. We'll see if I pick the right, the correct side. So then we'll start here. First end of street here. No, why aren't you? Okay. Pick nearest end point. Yeah. Now then. All right, now we have some problems, as we see here. Up in this, some of these are a little bit too close to the guard tower, but that's okay. We pick them up. Quick mode, control Q. Got to remember that. And I'll drag one here. I'll drag one here. And we redraw here. So that gives us some, put something there. So then we can zoom out a bit. And we have some room here. If I draw a street here, and it draws it close to that street, and then we pick, I think we want it on the other side based upon what I did last time. So now then I will pick this street, pick the start point, yeah. Why doesn't it want to draw here? Pick this street. So we pick this street, pick this, now. So now then we want to go on the left hand side and see if we can do this one. So we pick this street. So we pick the street, and then we come there. So that gives us rough, but we see that there are some problems. We obviously see that there are some organizational problems with the way the buildings lay out. However, it opens up some interesting things we can. Okay, so let's control Q. So if I'm just randomly move things around, so I move this building up here, and I pick up this thin building here, doesn't quite, it's a little bit too thick. Too bad. It's an interesting idea. But what happens is we can move this, well, we can leave this building here, and we can put, and let's move this building here, and we can move this building over here. And again, just by swapping a few buildings around, we get the space that looks a little bit better. Occasionally we have to redraw. So we get that there. Now then, this building here, slides over here. This building, let's see, this building here, we can slide here. And again, we have some larger buildings, so, and we have some smaller buildings. Move over here. So now then, how does this look? This looks okay. We still haven't, we gotta move that building there. Move that building there. Building there. And then move that building there. So, okay. So we fixed up most of this street here. So we can scroll over a little bit. And we see, you know, we still have some issues, but it's nothing terrible. We could actually delete this building. Might be the easiest, but, or we can move it here. Move it from street to street. So we get that. So we have a nice, we do have a gap there. And for that, we can come in and put in, I like a little bit more variety, so let's put in this building here. So we can put this building here. And now we can do there. So now we can, we can draw in the buildings manually as we go through. So this fixes up some of this street. So with the idea is that, oh, and then we should put another building. And what kind of building do we want on the end? Yeah, that one there. So insert. So we put this building here. No, escape. So, let's see. If we quick move this one here, and we move this one here, and then let's move that one there. What I'm doing is I'm just trying to make a little bit more room at the end of this street so that I have there. Now, let's go here. I can do that one. So to insert. So this is a big... Okay, Control Z. Now, edit redo. Now I still, okay, so this is the problem with drawing, you know, it's I can't remember settings. So the first thing, so the second step is to draw the, well, let's see. Let's draw here, here, here. No, okay. No, that's not what I... Now that... Redo. This is the problem, is trying to remember how to draw this type of building. See, if I draw it here, 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 then here... Okay, so then it's here, here, here. That's Control Z. So now then, let's draw that again. So insert. So I draw from here, here, here. Why does it keep... I want to rotate it 90 degrees, and obviously I'm being stupid. This is a stupid user problem. So if I draw here, here, here. Now that's still... Okay, now that was right. Here, here, here. Okay, we drew the, that's the building we want. Now, I want to adjust a few things more still. Like I said, there's always fun things. So that fits there. That fits there. Actually, some of these would be in, but could be in between the streets. So now we have a nice building like that. So that shows you a little bit of drawing up Campaign Cartographer, giving me a little idea how I'm going to populate all this up, and my plans for World of Tiglath. Thank you for watching. If you're interested, I'll do some more of these. I look forward to hearing what you think about this video. Let me know in the comments below. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you don't, it's okay. You can even give it a thumbs down. It says, if you're new here and want to subscribe, there is a button below, and there's some links to some content to the right. Thank you.